Hello students, in this class we are going to see regarding the structure of bacteria, that is the general account regarding the structure of bacteria. Here we see the bacteria. These have the wide diversity of shape and sizes. These bacteria basically have the wide ranges of shapes and the sizes. Their cells are about 1/10 the size of the eukaryotic cells. These 1/10 the size of the eukaryotic cells and are typically 0.5 to 5.0 micrometers in length. These are the typical ranges 0.5 to 5.0 micrometers in length. However, few species, that is for example, Theomargetia, Nimbiniasis and Eupilophysium Piscium Fischlsoni are up to the half a millimeter length. These are half a millimeter in length, long length, and are visible to the unaided eyes. These are visible to the unaided eyes. Here, especially this species ranges about 0.7 millimeter in size. Among the smallest bacteria are member of the genus that belongs to Mycoplasma. Genus that belongs to Mycoplasma are the smallest bacteria which measure only 0.3 micrometer. These measures about 0.3 micrometers, as small as the largest viruses. That is, this size equal to the largest size of the viruses. Some bacteria may be even smaller, but these ultra microbacteria are not well studied. These ultra microbacteria are not well studied for study purpose. This is the typical structure of the bacterial cell. Here we see the presence of RNA, that is the heredity material, lipid globule, the presence of mesosomes, the cell wall, the respiratory enzymes, this is the pilus, the filament, the present of the hook, flagellum, the present of flagellum, cytoplasm, mucilage, plasma membrane, nucleoid, polyribose and ribose. These are present in typical bacterial cell. Here, most bacterial species are either spherical. They are either spherical in size. Those are called coccoi. The singular form is coccus. These are from the Greek terminology, that is the coccos, which refers to the grain or seed. They resemble the shape of the grain or the seed, that spherical in shape, small the spherical in shape. Those are called the cocci. The singular form is the coccus. Or some, in case they are rod shaped, which are called as the bacilli. Spherical shaped bacteria are called the cocci. The rod shaped bacteria are called as the bacilli. The singular form is the bacillus. This is from the Latin terminology, which baculus, which means the stick. This guy, which means the stick. The elongation is associated with swimming. Some bacteria called Vibrio. Some bacteria are called Vibrio, are shaped like slightly curved rods. This kind, curved rods. Those are called the Vibrio or the comma shape. This kind, comma shape. Others can be a spiral shaped, which are called spirella, or the tightly coiled, those are called the spirochetes. Here, the spherical shape is called the cocci, the rod shape is called the bacilli, the comma shape or the slightly curved rods called the vibrio, the spiral shape is called the spirella, and the tightly coiled, that is called as the spirochetes. Here, number of the species even have tetrahedral or cuboidal shapes. These some of the these species also have the tetrahedral or cuboidal shapes. More recently, bacteria were discovered deep under earth crust that grows as the branching filamentous types with a star-shaped cross section. Here, with the recent discovery, we find the bacteria under the earth crust that grows as the branching filaments, that grows as the branching filaments type with the star-shaped cross section. When we take the its cross section, it resembles like a star. The large surface area to volume ratio of this morphology may give these bacteria an advantage in nutrient poor environment. These bacteria, the morphology gives these bacteria an advantage in nutrient poor environments. The wide variety of shapes is determined by the bacteria cell wall and cytoskeleton and is important because it can influence the ability of bacteria to acquire nutrients, attach to the surfaces, swim through lipids and escape from the predators. The many bacterial species exist simply as single cells, other associated in characteristic patterns like Neisseria form diploid, that is pair diploid, two in numbers, diploid, that is the pairs, streptococcus, that is the chain form. The streptococcus, these are chain in nature, chain, they forms the chain. Staphylococcus, that group together which assemble like a bunch of grapes, that is cluster, we get in cluster form, that is the bunch of grapes, that is staphylococcus. Bacteria can also be elongated to form filaments. These bacteria can also be elongated to form a filaments. For example, actinobacteria. Actinobacteria is the example where we can see in the filaments form. The filamentous bacteria are often surrounded by the sheet that contains many individual cells. These filament bacteria are often surrounded by the sheet that contains many individual cells. If it is the filament, that is the sheet that is covered by the cells. These contain individual separate cells. Certain types, such as species of the genus Nocardia, even form complex branched filaments similar in appearance to the fungal mycelia, which resemble the fungal mycelia, where in the case of genus Nocardia. The bacteria often attach to the surface and form dense aggregations, which are called as the biofilms or bacterial mats. These bacteria often attach to the surface and form dense aggregations. Those are called biofilms. Those are called biofilms or the bacterial mats. These films can range from a few micrometers in thickness to up to a half a meter in depth. These ranges from these bacterial mats or the biofilm, which ranges from few micrometer thickness to up to the half a meter in depth and may contain multiple species of bacteria, that is the protist and the archaea, that is the protist and archaea. Bacteria living in biofilms display a complex arrangement of cells and extracellular components, forming secondary structures such as microcolonies through which there are network of channels to enable a better diffusion of nutrients. Here, these biofilms display the complex arrangement. What is these biofilms? These forms the complex arrangement of cells and extracellular components, forming secondary structure such as microcolonies. They form the microcolonies through which there are the networks of channels to enable the better diffusion of nutrients in the environment. In natural environments such as soil or the surface of the plants, the majority of bacteria are found to surfaces in the biofilms. In natural environments such as in the soil, the surface of plants, the majority of bacteria are bound to surfaces in the biofilms form. Next, the biofilms are also important in medical field, that is in the preparation of the medicine, as these structures are often present during the chronic bacterial infections or in infections of implanted medical devices, and bacteria protected within biofilms are much harder to kill than individual isolated bacteria, because these biofilms make a micro colonies. Those are complex structure which study as the secondary structure. Those are the complex compared to the individual bacteria. Hence, they are very hard to kill the biofilms. Even more complex morphological changes are sometimes possible. Here, even we can see the changes in this structure. For example, when starvated of amino acids, Maxobacteria detected surrounding cells in a process known as quorum sensing, migrated towards each other and aggregate to form fruiting bodies up to 500 micrometers long and containing approximately 1 lakh bacterial cells. This is for the example in when starved of amino acids, the Maxobacteria detect it surrounding the cells. The process is called the surrounding of the cells. The process is called the quorum sensing, which migrated toward each other and aggregate to form separate cells. They come aggregated to make a complexity, which these forms a fruiting body, which are 500 micrometers long and contain approximately 1 lakh of bacterial cells. In these fruiting bodies, the bacteria perform separate tasks. This type of cooperation is a simple type of multicellular organism. Here, in this case of the fruiting bodies, the bacteria perform separate tasks. This type of the cooperation is a simple type of multicellular organization. For example, many cells migrate to the top of these fruiting bodies and differentiate into a specialized dormant state that is called as the mixiospores. The dormant state is called the mixiospores, which are more resistant to drying and other diverse environmental conditions than the ordinary cells. This differs from ordinary cells because they resist more drying and other adverse environmental condition, where in the case of mixiospores. Next, we see the bacterial surface. What all the we seen in the diagram, the bacterial cell, where we found the cell wall, the outermost layer, the cell wall. Here, under the cell wall, we are going to study in detail regarding the gram-positive cell wall and the gram-negative cell wall. In detail, we are going to study regarding the gram-positive cell wall of bacteria and the gram-negative cell wall of the bacteria. Next, the presence of the plasma membrane and the presence of the flagella or the flagellum and the presence of the pili in detail in our next class. Next class, we are going to see regarding the cell wall in detail, the gram-positive and the gram-negative. Next, the presence of plasma membrane and its function, the flagellum or the flagella, the presence of pili, that is also sometimes called the fimbriae. This we are going to see in our next class. Thank you.